Dear students, in the simple linear regression model, we have considered many functional forms like log-log model, log-log model to estimate elasticity, log-linear model to estimate growth rates, lin-log model to estimate, for example, Angel's expenditure function, reciprocal models, and many other models are considered. Now, in the context of multiple linear regression model also, let us see a few functional forms. The first functional form which we consider is the functional form familiar to you, namely the Cobb-Douglas production function. Now, the Cobb-Douglas production function in stochastic form can be written as yi summum beta 1, x 2i raised to beta 2, x 3i raised to beta 3, e raised to u, where y is output, x2 is labor, x3 is capital. The Cobb-Douglas production function. And as it is known to you, in appearance, it is not a linear model. Not a linear model, but it is intrinsically linear because it is not linear in parameters, but it is an intrinsically linear model. Because by giving a suitable transformation, we can convert this model into a linear one. So we give a conversion ln yi summum ln beta 1 plus beta 2 ln x2 y plus beta 3 ln x3 y plus u. If you give into ui, then ui become ln ui, it become log normal distribution. The properties of log normal distribution is not specified by us, so we give it as e raised to ui. You cannot give it as plus ui because it cannot be converted into a log linear model because log a plus b is not equal to log a plus log b. So we give it as e raised to ui. Now, this can be written as ln yi summa beta 0 plus beta 2 ln x2 y plus beta 3 ln x3 y plus ui. Remember this, we specify u as e raised to ui as earlier. The reason is, if you specify it as into ui, when transformation is given, it become ln ui log normal distribution. Or you cannot write it as plus ui because it become a non-linear model. That is why we always specify it as e raised to ui. Now, as it is known to you, it is an example of a log-log model, log-linear model. All the variables are in log form. And as it is known to you from your microeconomic course, beta 2 is the partial elasticity of output with respect to labor, dou ln yi by dou ln x2 is equal to beta 2. And dou ln yi is dou y by y divided by dou x2 by x2. Or simply delta y by y divided by delta x2 by x2. That is the elasticity of output with respect to x2. That is, beta 2 measures the percentage change or the proportionate change in output when there is a 1% change in x2, keeping x3 constant. Similarly, dou ln yi by dou ln x 3i is equal to beta 3 or dou y by y divided by dou x 3 by x 3. That is the partial elasticity of output with respect to capital. Now, the sum of beta 2 and beta 3 give us information about the nature of returns to scheme. We know that if beta 2 plus beta 3 is equal to 1, beta 2 plus beta 3 is equal to 1, production function exhibits constant returns to scale. If beta 2 plus beta 3 is less than 1, decreasing returns to scale. If beta 2 plus beta 3 is greater than 1, increasing returns to scale. So if you have data on outputs, labor and capital, you estimate the model. Then the numerical values of beta 2 and beta 3 will give you an information about the nature of the returns to scale. We can test it, that we will see in the next session. If beta 2 plus beta 3 is 1, this production function exhibits constant returns to scale. If it is less than 1, diminishing returns to scale. If it is greater than 1, increasing returns to scale. So this is the most widely used production function to estimate the most widely used functional form to estimate production function. And from your microeconomic class, the properties of this production function is very much familiar to you. This production function exhibits any returns to scale, can be constant, increasing or diminishing. Elasticity of substitution is 1. Expansion path is a straight line. Isoconst generated by this production function is convex, and so many other things. And we will see more about this when we consider hypothesis testing in the context of multiple linear regression model. We can test whether this production function exhibits constant returns, diminishing returns, or increasing returns. That is a topic which we will come later. So this production function must always be kept in mind. This is extensively used in the books of econometrics. You will see a lot of worked out examples of production function using Cobb-Douglas production function, and the procedures adopted to test whether the production function exhibits constant, diminishing, or increasing returns to scale. Another functional form which we extensively use in microeconomics is the cubic cost function. We know that total cost is a function of quantity. In microeconomics, the total cost curve is always given like this. This is the shape of the total cost curve. The standard shape, total cost. Total cost, total variable cost, total cost, like this. Total fixed cost plus total variable cost, that is total cost. Now, in the form of an equation, this can be written as yi is equal to beta 1 plus beta 2 x2y plus beta 3 beta 2 xi plus beta 3 xi square plus beta 4 xi raised to 3 plus ui. A standard total cost curve is represented by a cubic cost function where y is total cost, x is quantity. So we take a quantity, square of the quantity, and cube of the quantity. Now the question is, A cubic function can have different shapes. Now, what restrictions should be placed on these coefficients to get this shape? The restrictions are beta 0, beta 1, and beta 3 greater than 0, beta 2 is less than 0, beta 2 square is less than 3, beta 1, beta 3. These are the restrictions imposed on the coefficients to ensure that the shape of the total cost curve is this. So once we estimate the model, we can check whether these restrictions are satisfied or not. So if you have data on cost and output, you plot this observation in the form of a graph and observe the pattern, whether the pattern is like this or not. If the pattern is something like this, then fit this. Beta 1 is fixed cost, and this part is total variable cost, and this is total cost. So total cost is equal to total fixed cost plus total variable cost. Now, other functional forms, the use of non-sample information, outside information, and many other issues will be considered when we discuss the problem of inference in the context of multiple linear regression models.